And now you're under my control.
Mike makes your day. He brings you the world, the stars and the songs. Mike makes your day. He does what you like to. He takes you along.
Welcome
and
back.
He said minutes instead of days, which it just really upped the joke. And for that, he won a Let's Do This official Nobody Likes Onions shot glass.
I hope it's a guy who's like never heard of NLO before and he doesn't hate the melt.
Congratulations, bro. Very, very good. Very, very good. All right. We've got some amazing content coming up, believe it or not.
Should we go into the woods?
Yeah. Let's take a trip deep down. In the deep, dark woods of podcasting. Right now. Here we are. We're going into the woods. You want to come into the woods with me? The woods are very scary. Lions and tigers and me, oh my! I like to, does any other podcast wave as if they're on a float passing through a parade? Sometimes I think a transition on the show is just me waving to you guys as if I'm passing by on a float. Hello.
Thank you.
But pretty funny. What is this saying? Oh, yeah. Here it comes. Let's have a drink. Here we go. Are we out of the woods? Are we out of the woods? It's the woods, huh? If you're a podcaster in today's day and age, you are in the woods. Your background consists of unfinished, fake, reclaimed gray wood panels. And boy, you thought you heard everything about the background wood look on this show. Well, think again. We have got a lot of new wood talk that we must address today because Joe Rogan has gone full woodsman. It's truly remarkable. I mean, I've been making fun of it for years. And I think I do have to explain the difference because I'm watching people who even agree with me. I'm watching them roast wrong. And I guess let's pull up a picture of, like, Theo's set, Jules. Why don't you send that over?
I got the list all in the woods note.
Podcasters, for some reason, no matter how much money or how little money they have, they like to do a background that is wood panels. It's called a DIY wood paneled feature wall, and these came out in about 1998. In fact, they became popular in 2004. You would go to a restaurant, a cheap, shitty, by the way, when I say restaurant, I mean, you know, one above fast food, some crazy place like Epic Burger. Go to Epic Burger. You ever been to Epic Burger? They've got a feature wall, and it'll be one wall with the fucking wood on it. It is a cheap way to give a wall some texture. It was never intended to be part of TV. It was never intended to be a set. It was never intended to be for the rich. If you make under $40,000 a year and you want to have a DIY decor project as your backdrop, go for it. But when you've got over $100 million in the bank, you should not be gluing fake reclaimed stick-on wood to your wall. It's flooring, for God's sakes. I don't know if these people think it looks good. I don't know if they think it looks trendy. To me, again, when I see a wall like that, I think of like a 2004 hip fake-ass, shitty taco place that everybody thinks was good for 2 weeks, but then realizes it's actually kind of shitty, and it's got a script font. I mean, come on. We're talking a Pinterest board from 8 years ago with this goddamn
longer
wood
than
panel.
Like,
What's that?
Longer than eight.
Oh, scroll. Longer than eight.
Scroll down. Okay. Those are the new examples, and then after the break are the old
examples. Okay, so let's show you. Just here's an example here of Theo Vaughn. Yeah, of course. And this is the type of wood paneling I have. Wow, those are some.
Those ones are extra.
Those are wise. So let's go through a journey through podcaster planks. Right. Podcaster planks. Everybody's got them. It's the new wall in podcasting. And this is when, of course, you go to Home Depot and you go, do you have any of that really cheap flooring that I could glue to a wall? And they say, oh, yes, here. And you put it on your wall. So here it is. And it's usually in these weird tones, almost blue. They're all going like blue, like navy blue wood, gray, and tan and brown. Again, if this were on your floor, you're not going to hear from me.
If this was on your floor, specifically this one.
But not in a studio. If he had this on the floor of his studio.
Okay, fine.
So here's Theo Vaughn. He's got the wood walls, okay? And I've got so many new points here today. Let's go to Chris D'Elia.
We all know this one.
Oh, we know this one. Here's another wood wall. And it's almost identical to what Theo had there. And it's always an unfinished wood. All right? And we want to talk about the differences today with this wood wall thing. You know, I see some listeners, they'll point out like this beautiful office, like Don Draper's office in Mad Men with the, what do they call that type of wood?
Like wainscoting?
The walnut, and it's beautiful. And they'll be like, look, wood wall. Those aren't the type of wood walls we're against. You are allowed to put the material wood on a wall. You're just not allowed to use flooring on your wall like this, okay? There are ways to do wooden wall features. And by the way, it's supposed to be on one wall, feature wall. You are not supposed to make a whole wooden.
I mean, not necessarily. You can do a whole wooden office.
Well,
that
sure,
looks
sure. But not with that. Not
of
with that.
Of course not.
That technique has been used, what they're using there. But you would do it on a feature wall in a kid's basement if you make 60 grand a year and you live in the suburbs, right? Let's show you another one. Nobody likes onions. Yeah, we saw this earlier today. Even they have a wood. Oh, look, a guest, but he's in front of, unfinished cheapo wood wall. And, you know, a lot of the problem is the cost. They're picking the lowest grade, least expensive wood because it's supposed to be a fun DIY weekend project that you see on Home and Garden magazine. It was never. This is the only Joe Matarese example we have. He's covered in frames. This is what
I know. He actually improved his a little bit.
What are you
bit.
Talking about? You couldn't find a better one than that? Good mother of God. You know, we're interrupting the whole flow here.
I think he deletes a lot of his videos.
Oh, that's why.
So
okay. Yeah, he's deleted it.
Just the wood walls are gone.
Yeah,
so I was just using that as more
just
of a
take
reminder.
It from me. Joe Matarese has a wood wall. Yeah.
And I'm sure there's many more we're not even thinking of. Impulsive, but I didn't add theirs because theirs at least is fine.
Well, yeah, impulsive is on the list. Yeah, I wanted that one too. Here's the problem today, because I couldn't believe it could get any worse. And every time somebody comes out with a new set, we make a joke. We go, let me guess, it's going to be a wood planked wall. And then it actually, we can't even believe it anymore. So many of you know what this is leading to. Yesterday, on Instagram, Tom Segura posted this. Yep, Joe Rogan has built his new studio, and it is the largest wood wall we've seen yet. It is the most reclaimed. And by the way, by reclaimed, I mean not reclaimed. These are companies making fake reclaim planks. Do you understand? It's not actually wood from a barn. Joe Rogan went full wood. His desk is wood. Remember, they made fun of the studio. We made fun of the studio with Tom Green. It was Tom Green. He just said, this is a spaceship. We're moving. Wait till you see. Okay, you don't like this red studio that I did actually intend to build, by the way. Do, 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 do.
You need more Wawa?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, can you get me a cold one? Give me a cold one. I'm dying. I'm like ready for a cold drink. What was I saying?
The spaceship, Tom Green.
The spaceship. He goes, oh, we got a studio. You're going to love it. And this is what he came back with. It is probably his worst studio to date. It's equally crap. And you know what? It's fine. I guess it's fine. It's very hard to do this segment because it's fine for Patrick Melton. If Patrick Melton wanted to have this studio, that's the level of guy that should have this studio. Joe Rogan has over 100 million USD. This is a DIY project. This is no decorator required for this project. Now, some of you have been distracted by a giant neon sign, which I'll say I love neon. I'll tell you this. I'm a big sucker for neon signs. I like neon signs almost all the time. When I see neon, I get excited. I like lights. I like light up stuff, and I worry because I go, are they going to kill neon? I think they are going to kill neon. I'll tell you why. I love neon. All my life, I don't know if I've ever been open and honest about this. All my life, I've loved neon. I've been attracted to it as a kid. I felt the power of neon. There must be something within neon that draws us. To me, neon is a, you know why? I think it's like it first appeared in bars. And as a kid, a bar was like an adult, cool utopia of God knows what goes on in these bars. But they got neon. I love fucking neon. She loves neon. I was telling, do you hear what I said?
That your word neon is going to go out of style.
I'll give me the whole bottle. We're on E! Entertainment. And by the way, this is just a regular Nestle small bottle of water. That's to show scale of how big I am. Guys, I'm sorry. I'm so dehydrated today. I'm on my new medicine. They said do not drink with it because it could cause extreme dehydration.
Okay.
So I'm, that's not true. Can I have a few sips? Too cold. I could drink more water than anyone. Okay, take this away. I love neon. And I fear they're going to take neon away from me. I'll tell you why. And I hate to say it, but I've been wanting to tell you this for a while. They've concocted a way to do fake neon signs using LED lights. Yes, have you seen this? They use plastic tubes. Okay. So like a neon light is like a glass tube. It filled with a neon gas, right? And it illuminates. It costs money to make a neon sign. It takes talent to make a neon sign, and it can't just be made overnight, and it can't be bought overnight, and it's hard to do, and it's breakable. It's delicate, okay, and it's difficult. So when a company, or when you saw a neon sign in 1995, it meant something. It meant somebody really invested in what this sign wanted to say. When you saw a neon sign, you go, this costs like $1,000 here for that. It's not cheap. A glass blower had to fucking bend these tubes and all this shit. So it meant something. And now they have LED neon. And in a picture, it looks like a neon light. But it's just a plastic tube with like cheap LEDs behind it. Made to mimic a neon sign. Now, Joe's is actually real neon. I took a look. It's real. It's the glass tubes. Okay. But I fear, because you're seeing neon everywhere now, I fear when you cheapen the product like that and then everybody has access to it and everybody could use it, are we going to stop liking it? Is it going to become a cheap sign like the wood wall became? Is it going to become lame?
I like neon, and Tim Dillon and Joe Rogan both put up neon signs within the last 2 months. They're kind of taking away neon from me.
Everyone has taken it away. It's the they most have popular every, thing.
Yeah, you're right. Everyone's taken it away. Where I felt like I had a... So he's got this, and I'll say it's... I think all neon signs are cool, and you get tricked by them. When you actually look at it, it's pretty lame. It's a spaceship. It's just his name. It says Texas. But it lights up. A light up sign is always cool.
I mean, even a neon sign of Chrissy Mars gums would rule to me.
Guys, yeah. I like light up signs so much that some days I'll just drive to the local Baskin Robbins and park my car and be in awe of that big plastic 21 Flavors logo. I mean, I just like a sign. The Subway sign. You go to Subway? Subway. It's plastic. It's cool. Lights up. So he got the neon sign, don't be distracted, but he's in front of a wood wall. Would you like to see his first episode with Tom Segura? And it's more troubling than this. His video quality has somehow degraded. I couldn't believe it. His video quality, and I have examined this with a fine-tooth monocle, Joe Rogan's video quality right now is worse than Anthony Cumia's. It is more pixelated and more low-def than Cumia himself. This man has access to $100 million U.S. dollars. So I go on his Instagram, I go, hire the decorator. Maybe even hire the same decorator that you use for your multiple multi-million dollar homes. You know, the homes that your wife wouldn't be caught dead in if they looked like this.
I know. Like, what is
Joe
the
has
disconnect?
Mansions with every room is done to the nines. You would never have a shit room like this in Joe's house. I'm telling you, when you see Joe's house, like, he has, like, a butler's kitchen. That is nicer than any kitchen you'll ever have. Every room is done up. And so you go, Joe.
Here, dude. Actually, I just looked at this house, and the first picture is a room with wood walls, but they're not that cheap.
Okay, let's show you. So why can't these guys go, I'm going to hire a set decorator to build me a set? Why do they just go, I don't want to pay any money? Here's what bothers me. It's not that they fucked up. It's not that they took an L. It's that they won't spend their money on their shows. That somehow, and for some reason, really bothers me. If I had $100 million, this show would be broadcast in Times Square on all the screens. And I would be conducting mass massacre from those steps, those red steps. So when I see somebody with this much money put in so little, oh my God, the man's obsessed.
There's so much wood.
Okay. Holy fuck. This is Joe Rogan's house. Look at this foyer. That is like a 1500 square foot room with 20 foot ceilings. And it is head to toe floor. That is flooring.
I mean, it doesn't look awful there, obviously, because it's done well, awful, but it's not what I would pick.
No, I would go ahead and say this is also a huge no-no. You do not put flooring on your fucking walls. I don't care what people say. I don't understand why there is a way to do wood. I've been to so many, like, apartments where they have, like, wood walls, but it's like a full wall of, like, wood. What do you call it? It's like, can we show an example of what I'm talking about, the wood I like? Can you find like a, you know, like when you see like a wood walled library, like a cigar library that's like very rich with wood walls. That's cool. Wainscoting. Joe Rogan's house.
My opinion is.
Oh my God! Another fucking look at this.
Yes, there's tons of wood in here.
So the man's obsessed with wood.
I think it's like all you have to do is use your eyes, look at the wood. Does it look good? It's good. Does it look
bad?
Now
this looks good.
It's bad.
Look at this. Is another. This is Joe Rogan's dining room. We're not joking. But that's what I mean. It's like obviously you look at these rooms. There was a decorator hired to do it. Can you not invest in your show? Like when you watch TV, right? it's not just the host does it himself over the weekend.
It's hard to find a picture of wood walls that you want to show. Because
I know,
because
you don't
like,
want to be made fun of.
Something that you're not 100% in love with.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I left
you
to do
what
it.
I mean.
They don't.
Like, imagine like a 70s vibe.
Don't, Jules. You'll get yourself in so much trouble.
Exactly. See, it's too hard.
I know.
I feel like people who know what you mean.
They don't. It's such a shame because you know what? I'm sitting here arguing my head off about decor when half of these people can't even see color.
But
probably.
I think the most important thing, wood or not, is if it looks good and it looks like someone put some effort into it to make it look like. And also, I don't think that it's appropriate on a set. Like, wood in your home is one thing.
No, I think wood works in a set, not that kind of wood.
Yeah, maybe.
Because I know that one day I will have a wood feed. There will be wood on our walls in a set. And it's going to be the good wood. And I know half of you are going to go, wood walls! So I got to put a stop to this now.
No, because I don't think, like...
You got to have wood somewhere.
But, of course, you got to have wood somewhere, but just nothing else in your set but a plain wood wall that you're sitting in front of, and it's just, like, the shittiest, cheapest-looking wood.
I know.
That's the problem. That's like, if Joe had a wood wall, like, the impulsive set, like I was saying before, I don't really like it, and it's still stupid flooring on the walls, but at least it looks like they made a design, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, Joe's studio is not designed. It's... wood stapled to the wall, and that's all they worried about.
It.
They didn't do nothing.
And it's such a fuck you to every... I want an investment in that background. I don't care if you don't care. I care, and it matters. Doesn't matter if you don't know that it matters. It matters.
Like, think about how much money you make a year on the show and what percentage of it you spend on the equipment and stuff. We want Joe spending that percentage of his income
on his equipment. Here's the real problem. The video cameras. Joe Rogan is using, if I went to buy the cameras Joe has, you could buy each of them for about $450 right now, used on eBay. They are video cameras. They are 3 CCD chip cameras. They are Canon GL2s. Do you know what those are? Is that even right? And they look awful. Hire someone now. I really won't put up with it. You need to hire a professional. You have millions of people. You're making millions of dollars. It needs to be a professional production. It has to be. And I don't want these people, you know, you got these confused people. Dude, man, who cares? As long as I care. And it matters. Shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. Stay out. Stay out of this conversation. It matters. And if you went to a movie, if you went to see the latest Iron Man and it was all DIY, just made by whose Iron Man was his name? Robert Downey Jr. If Robert Downey Jr. said designed just the whole fucking movie.
I was going to say John Favreau.
Yeah. Can I have that? You'd be disappointed. You want production, whether you know it or not. It will help your experience. And if you're going to spend that many hours with the man, it needs to vibe well. It needs to, you know. So I was thinking about that. I get really mad at that. And then I look around. I go, well, my set's not that great, you know. And I definitely could probably do better now. So you know what? I decided to do so. And... well, we've been working on this for a long time, but I think it's time to really put it in full gear here. And, you know, well, we're working on some things and we have some new ideas. At first, we were going to do the studio in our home here. And then we kind of thought about it a little bit and we thought that... maybe it would be better to rent, like, a big space and make the set of our fucking dreams. And so, starting next week, Jules and I are going to be looking for warehouse space to build something that is way better than anything you're seeing here in podcasting. And we think that these people deserve better. And how funny would it be if we're just ripping on people, but we have this amazing facility to do so in?
I would be so excited. I'm always hitting my funny bone in this place.
I know. It really is too small.
There's too many TVs.
And
so we're going to start work on that now.
Don't get excited. We just came up with this idea, so we still have to make it happen.
And I'm sure nothing will come of it, but that's what we hope.
But if it happens, it won't be like a long thing like when we moved cities, because we'll be moving somewhere in the same city.
Yeah. So, and we'll be doing this show in here while that one is being built. So I'm dying. I'm like dying to go out and start that experience right now. And then I'm going, you know, it's only us. It's just our minds. And basically everything you see on the show, all the design, everything you see is just us doing it. All the lighting. We don't hire anybody or do anything.
Yeah, this is.
Yeah, it kind of, yeah.
That's what we want.
We really have no idea. It's really hard. I want to be honest with people, because when people go, who cares what the set is? Who cares? Well, it's just because you haven't seen anything that's really cool yet, you know? Maybe you would care if you saw something that was really cool. But I get a lot of people go, who cares, Mike? It doesn't matter what the set is. Just get to the fucking content already. Who cares? Well, I do. I think it'll be really cool. And I think it'll be much more intuitive. But I don't know what to do, because we watched the Fools here, and the setup is kind of like this. Like, what else? It's really hard to design a set and to figure out what to do with it. But there's
I think what we already have is amazing. It just needs to be bigger, better, and more bombastic.
I want it to just be like, when you see it, it stops you in your tracks. Because imagine we're making fun of these fools. We're putting this on YouTube. People are seeing it. And imagine you're making fun of somebody as simple as Gino, but it's in this, you know, million-dollar space. It confuses the mind. It would create this drama. It would create a moment, you know, and that's important, man. I think people are forgetting. You gotta... Don't you want to do something? This is what I mean. It's like, if I had $100 million, I would be putting on a spectacle like you've never seen before. Why not treat the world to your wildest fantasy? I mean, it kills me to know there's a man who says he's a comedian and he's got $100 million and he's not doing anything to entertain you with it. Or like, do it. You know what I mean? I can't tell you what the crazy things that I would do if I had that money. And how fun it would be. And I just feel like you should put that money to use, especially when it's been given to you via this podcast. Can't you give back and just do something awesome? But no, Joe Rogan went on and spent maybe 15 to 20 grand on this shitty new studio with the shittiest cameras in podcasting. Here is the big problem. Why are Joe's cameras and video quality worse than almost anyone in podcasting?
Wait till you fucking see this. You got to show them what
the
you
video?
Mean. It's worse than you're even thinking. It's
where do we go?
It's the second link in the Joe Rogan list.
Wood panel?
No. Yeah.
Wood panel.
And then Joe Rogan and then two.
This one?
Yep.
Look at this. His latest episode. It's him and Tom Segura. It's the latest studio. And people were flipping out. They were seeing this in... the Bring Back group, our Facebook group, they go, wait, this is new? I thought this was like an old clip from 2004 you were playing. Watch this.
Joe Rogan Experience.
We should probably tell people what happened. If people who don't know, don't pay attention.
Here it is, folks. The Joe Rogan Experience. Now, what you can't see here, I'm sweating like crazy.
You want me to turn the fan up one?
Yeah, it's you might as well at this point. Here it is. What you can't see. Jules, why don't you post the link to this in the chat when you get back? You have to see the video quality. It is literally Anthony Cumia level pixelation. The color. It's so desaturated. You've got some scrambled egg neon light back there. And when you tune in, I'll tell you this. I was watching this on our TV late at night about 2:45 a.m. anytime I reference something that's late, I'm going to be saying 2:45 a.m. from now on. Pay attention to that. And what does that number mean? By the way, a lot of little things. I want people. You have OCD? You're autistic? Start getting in all these little things. They're going to add up one day. Every word out of my mouth is purposeful and planned and conspiratorial. 2:45 a.m. You remember that. And I was tuning this in. The neon is, in fact, so bright that it's like the Seinfeld episode where they put the chicken neon across
it
from
looks
Kramer.
Like King Kong sitting on top of a theater.
He really does. And I lowered the LED light, the backlight, as far as it could go in our room last night to zero. And usually our screen is so dim that you could sleep. I was going like this from it. Joe screwed up again, put this giant fucking neon right in our face. But what's even worse is the pixelation. If you're hearing breeze, it's we turn the fan on. But just think like we're doing a show from a resort in Miami, like Andrew Schultz.
To be fair, he does mention in the episode that the light looks really stupid.
Well, yeah,
so he
no,
must be being
no, no,
that.
No, not to be fair, to be equal. This is great. Wait till you hear what he says. Mike, I really hope that new studio works out perfect how you want it. You are the best at what you do. Thank you. And people believe this. You should see the messages I get. I am like a huge person in this life for some people. Okay. There's going to be an epic studio one day. You believe me. You'll see. You'll see. You'll all see. There are some people who think I'm never going to get new this studio. And boy, are they going to be.
It's better if they think that, because then when you do it, and then if you don't feel like it, then you don't have to do it because everyone thought you weren't going to anyway. It's no
Mike
pressure.
Is the best. We love you, Mike. Thank you. Please. This new studio is going to change podcasting. And we also have, it's not just a new studio. I came up with a, I could say this, I'll tell you this. I came up with an idea for some Redbar commercials. And thanks to the Iron Patriot, and thanks to a couple Shiva divas, I think I could tell this idea. I think we're going to commit to this. We're going out and buying a very expensive camera. Okay, I think it's time. We're going to upgrade our camera here, the very expensive, beautiful camera. You know, and it's going to at least be as good as Tom Green's camera that he's using for those beautiful desert videos. And I think that looks great.
Same.
And I don't know very much about cameras, believe it or not, anymore. So I will have to, there's going to be a learning curve here. I'm going to have to learn about this. But we're going to get this camera, and we're going to start making 30-second commercials. Beautifully filmed, cinematic, anti-fool commercials. Now, I haven't written any of these yet.
This is just an idea.
This is an idea, but I really want to go through
with it. Give
us a year. I really want to go through with this, and I want to film these very simple yet powerful cinematic anti-fool, anti, you know, all the Redbar messages that we come up with these commercials. And then I want to do what the Iron Patriot taught us, pay for them to be put in front of all the fools' YouTube videos and really do this as a full-time, like film 16 different little these vignettes. These little commercials that send one of Redbar's most important messages out into the earth, but in a beautiful way. And then film these and shoot these and then have these displayed in front of, yeah, you go to watch Kill Tony and it's going to be one of these commercials.
But the thing is, we want them to be like so impressive.
Beautiful. They have to be beautiful.
People are like blown away.
Yeah.
So you got to give us a couple months to practice becoming amazing at filming.
So I'll tell you why I'm inspired. But first of all, I'm pretty good at all this stuff anyway. I mean, you know, I'm pretty good at all this stuff.
We'll figure it out.
And Tom Green's vlogs right now, like go look at Tom Green's latest. They're beautiful. And you know what? It's just him kind of playing around with the camera by himself. He does it all by himself. And there's no reason I can't do that all by myself, right? And
or with your wife.
So when I saw, well, with you, yeah. And then when I saw Tom Green do it, I go, you know, we got to do something like this because I think that looks really good. And imagine what we could do with our little messages if shot like that and displayed and really show these comedians. You know, because what pisses me off is these comedians have the money to do what they should be doing. So what I want to do is top what they could never even reach. You know what I mean? Like, I want to do, I want to put out levels of production so high that it will take Joe Rogan 10 years, it'll take Theo Vaughn, all of them, 10 years to catch up. And by that time, we're out of here.
It's almost not even that hard because everyone else's production quality is so shitty that even the most minimal amount of effort will blow people away.
Exactly. And I think it will be very funny. So I think this was our plan. What we were going to do was we do all this, and look how it's all starting to come together. We do all this four-wheel driving, off-roading. Now, listen to this. We go to all these beautiful locations, Moab, every weekend, by the way. And I don't tell you guys about it because it's boring, but every weekend we basically go to like an off-roading camping thing like almost every week. And we'll go to Joshua Tree, we'll go to Moab, we'll go to all these places, and it's beautiful there. And what we thought is we'll buy this good camera and we'll practice, we'll learn how to film while we're out at these locations, because I frankly find myself very bored while I'm out there. So, for instance, we'll four-wheel drive. I like that part. But then when we get to the places and you get out of the car, you go, okay. All right. Now what do? You know, just walk around. I don't like that. So while I'm there anyway, I'll use that time to get good at filming like Tom Green did. And then I'll use that experience to come back and film these commercials by myself with Jules.
That's the plan.
And then we'll upload them to you. Now, will this ever happen? I don't know. But
there's a, I'd say 50-50 chance.
How much of a chance? Would you should think 50-50 or more?
50-50 is totally fair at this point in time.
I'll tell you this.
We'll let you know if the percentage raises.
I'll tell you this. Because it does change. Here's the thing about me. It's not that I'm lying. What if in 2 weeks it's just not, I don't like the idea that much anymore.
Exactly.
That's why.
Because most people don't say their ideas till they're already done.
Yeah.
And you get excited and say them immediately.
But
that's fine. You got to get it out and see if it's a good idea.
Here's the difference. I've had this idea for a long time. I think it's time and I think it's the right moment. And we could really rub it in these comedians' faces with these commercials, I think. I think we could really creatively rub. I always imagine pushing Tony Hinchcliffe's face into the sand, you know?
They're saying Mike's new drugs must really be working.
They're only anti-inflammatories. Don't get excited. They don't do anything to the mind. Do you want the commercials or not?
I'm excited about this idea, so I'm going to push him to do it.
I think we could do it. And I'll tell you this. Here's what I'm afraid of.
The only way that we wouldn't do it is if we realized we couldn't do it as good as we thought we could. Because that's the thing that you never want to
do. Oh, I'm not worried about that. I'm just worried about, you know, it becomes a lot. Everything becomes work. Everything that you think is easy becomes a lot of work. Like, we were decorating a living room. It's not even that big. It's taking months. It's still not done. Like, just ordering enough furniture to fill a living room is like a 7-month project. Yeah. And figuring it out, it really is like every project is a project. Everything takes a lot. And if you want anything to come out good, it's a lot of work. Like designing a single room is very hard if you really want it to look good. We've been working on our living room for how many months? 4 months.
I mean, that's why most people's rooms don't look good. It's too fucking hard.
Exactly. It really is too hard. Even if you have all the money. And this was the first time I was able, first time in my life, that I was able to design a room with no restriction, literally almost no restriction. Like I could literally go out and get everything I want for this room designed, our living room, today. But I can't. And I couldn't believe it. I just thought if you had the money, boom, there's a room, beautiful room.
You got to order and wait, baby.
But it's not even just order and wait. First of all, you have to hope these products exist.
Oh, yeah.
Because they don't just exist. This is what you think. It's like, I want to design a room and make it look so badass. Okay. Go online, try to find these cool items that you think exist.
That's why you pay a designer, because they know exactly where to get all the cool shit.
The only people that actually, you really got to pay a designer. It really is a full-time job. We can't even get this living room done. We've been sweating away at it. I'm still unsatisfied. Fucking bar stools still.
We have high expectations,
I know,
too.
But it really is crazy. And you go to, like, a store, even, like, Crate and Barrel, you got to wait 5 months to get bar stools.
And it's, like, 10 years ago, you would just put everything in your living room, and you're like, oh, this looks pretty good. I'm satisfied. But now you're seeing 10 million of the Earth's most amazing rooms every single day online. So everything you could do looks terrible compared to that.
Yeah.
So you
no,
have to
it
be
really
working
is, and it's
probably, so
yeah,
hard
when
to
you're
get
going
all these
through,
cool items and random
yeah,
because
you're going through Instagram and, you know, we're comparing ourselves with, like, the highest quality standards in the world. Yeah. And you're going, yeah, it's never going to be like that. So when it comes to a studio, it's actually very hard. Like, what would you do? Anyone got an idea? It really is hard. Like, there's not even an example of a studio on TV that I like. You know what I mean? So where do you even start? But I'll tell you where you don't start. And here we get back to my fools. I'll tell you where you don't start. You don't start by copying your shitty DIY peer. This is what I never understood. I was talking to Nerd City. He told me how a lot of people, when he came out with his videos that were very stylistic, that you didn't see on YouTube, a lot of people were copying. And I was thinking about it, and I was going, it's so weird. Why would they copy from their own industry? You know, if you're going to cop, like, if I was a YouTuber and I was building a YouTube set and I wanted to copy and didn't want to be creative, why not pull from movies or TV? Why would you pull from another shitty, underground, crappy DIY?
Like, who are you inspired by? Chris D'Elia? Like,
yeah, is Joe why is Joe Rogan copying Chris D'Elia? You should be copying The Tonight Show. You know what I mean? Like, copy from something good, at least, or from outside of your industry. It's like, copy something from a film. Don't copy something that's crap. Here's Tom Segura.
But
you know,
some people are, like, born. I know we've said this a million times, but those people who are like, take a picture, and then they take a picture, and you're like, this is the composition that you came up with in your mind. Some people are just, like, born without any sense of what things look like, or it's
so
crazy.
This is not the right clip. We need the Spotify. We're going to hear Joe Rogan talk about his.
I put that one because I thought you'd want to show the bad quality on YouTube. It's more clearly bad.
You should start your own show called Oh Sorry. I'm just kidding. At that point, I'm just kidding. Looks fucking terrible. The curtain is back. Yeah. You want to see Joe Rogan's new set and you want to hear what he has to say about it? Let's go to Spotify. And Joe Rogan now has video on Spotify, which is pretty cool. We could watch it again. So we might be back into covering Ronstein, although it's still very boring. You know who I hate? Dan Crenshaw. Oh, politics aside, guys, if you believe a word he's saying, you've been fooled. Dan Crenshaw is awful. Awful. Do you know what I did? I'm sitting here going, what the hell? It's not working. I went into Spotify. I went into the search bar. And I'm not kidding. Look what I've been typing.
Spotify. I do that all the time.
No wonder I can't find Joe Rogan. All right, let's try this again. Joe Rogan.
But I put the link in there. It didn't work.
Oh, I don't know. Here it is. It's his, look at this. We could go right on Spotify. Let's watch his latest episode with Tom Segura. There you go. Where are they going to come from this time?
The Joe Rogan Podcast Experience.
Train by day, Joe Rogan Podcast by night. All day.
It's not the meds. Those are anti-inflammatory. Here we go.
Hello, Tommy Buns.
Hello, Joseph.
Welcome to the new studio.
I love it.
You are guest number uno.
This is a great look, man.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
I mixed it up.
It's brighter.
Like a little bit of the old.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Okay, here you go. And let's see. Hopefully, will this cover-up thing go away? You know, we were so mad when Joe Rogan switched to Spotify. A lot of people were mad. Not for our reasons. When you pause on Spotify, it creates a gradient overlay with all this crap on it, darkening the image, so I can't pause to show you what I want to show you. Didn't you take a screenshot of his set or something like that that we could show people? Because you can't see, but here's this wide shot. It really looks terrible.
Oh, no, I was going to take a screenshot on this because the TV covers it up even more.
Yeah.
So
this
let me
is,
see if there's one on YouTube.
It's
I'll
okay.
Try to find
I'll
it.
Play you the episode. This is his new studio. If you remember his last studio in L.A., this one looks worse than it. So imagine that one, but a little bit worse. But with a neon sign. However, that neon sign is going to be taken away in a few days. Wait, Mike, take it away. Yeah. Listen to this. So it's just going to be that wood wall soon. Here you go.
Joe Rogan Podcast, check it out.
The Joe Rogan Experience.
Train by day, Joe Rogan Podcast by night.
No.
All day.
That's not my philosophy. Actually, it is.
Hello, Tommy Buns.
Here you
Hello,
go.
Joseph. Welcome to the new studio.
I love it.
You that are is actually what I do.
This is a great look, man.
Here,
thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
I mixed it up.
It's brighter.
Like a little bit of the old.
Yeah.
A little new.
Listen to this.
Some aliens here.
A little bit of alien shit. This might be annoying. My name behind me might be annoying. It looks cool, but it might not be cool. The right spot for it.
Yeah,
we'll figure that out.
It does look cool.
It's a little odd, though.
Yeah.
Like, well, me really. And then a big neon thing of my name right behind me.
Yeah. I sense you're going to move that.
It's when he said, I didn't even think it was that crazy until he said that. Then I'm like, oh, is this Joe Rogan? Oh, it is. Is this the Joe Rogan? Oh, yes. Joe Rogan. Does that come with you? Is that attached to your back? Do you walk around like one of those? What was that movie where they fought as robots with that guy from Sons of Anarchy? You know? He walks around with this giant neon sign stating who he is, and it matches his t-shirt, his AGA t-shirt.
Wow. Oh, my God. That would be such a good costume for next year's J.R.E.
I wear
costume.
This, but with that sign on my back, like that.
You can go to the clubs yeah. with it.
Imagine that. I need a replica Joe Rogan sign made ASAP with a backpack strap, and I need this yellow shirt and the bald cap. And then I walk around to bars, yes, in Austin. Who are you? I'm Joe Rogan's episode one of his new set with Tom Segura.
Okay. I looked at the image on the screen.
That would be like, funny.
Oh, that's not what I
Pacific Rim, yes.
It looked like. It looks dope, right? It's cool. It's Listen a cool up. Sign, but I just don't know if it's the right background.
Yeah. But so, the whole space looks great.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I like it.
Thank you.
The ceiling, the star. Did you see the shooting stars?
Yeah, we can't, so it doesn't matter. And Tom looks up. Yeah, I can see. I got bottle rockets in my studio. So
yeah, everybody those. Hated his red studio.
Yeah.
So like a bitch, he immediately went back to what he thought yeah. was most similar to his old studio. But it's like, can't you just hire someone? You're talking about how Austin is the most amazing place in the world. Shouldn't
yeah.
there be like America's most incredible designers living there? You have so much money.
Here, you want to watch me and Tom Segura watch fireworks? What did you think? I know it's beautiful, isn't it? I know. I love the 4th. A lot of fireworks this year, huh? Yeah. You're still looking up? Because they've stopped. That's the moon. I know. I love our Earth's moon. You're going to look at me? At this point, you're scared. Me and Tom Segura watching the fireworks there. It'd be nicer if I didn't have this fucking pause gradient over his
I know.
Head, ruining that whole bit. But
blame Joe.
You ever share a firework with Tom Segura? That's how it would happen. Here
yeah,
you go.
Dope, right?
Yeah, shit. It's very consistent.
How much better would it have been
when
if
all
he
your
was in gradient?
Still feels
damn
like you're in the
it was
same
still
kind
effective.
Of space.
Okay, you know it was effective.
The last one didn't. That one
well, that one I never
door?
Sat in. But
oh,
I mean,
that's right.
But when you know, like your second old L.A. studio.
Yeah.
When you moved it to your newer L.A. studio, it's like the...
Do you think a new L.A. studio? What kind of coat is this, by the way? Can we address your coat here?
Shiny.
What is that? That's that weird-ass denim. What do you call it? It's not...
Shiny denim. Diesel-style
Diesel
denim.
Style look at the buttons he's wearing. He's back to the kabuki getup here. You could tell that. I mean, and by the way, do you see the color difference here? I know we're on a pause gradient, but Jesus Christ, talk about grayscale, you know, the saturation knob. Joe hates that.
Oh, that's why I put the YouTube thing in so you could see their faces okay. without the gradient.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go over there.
But that's just talking about his injury. So, but they don't really
yeah,
say much
yeah,
else.
Yeah. But let's look at it here without the gradient.
The Joe Rogan Experience.
Okay. Yeah. Why the George Floyd family sound effect at the beginning there, if you're not indeed racist?
We should probably tell people what happened to you. For people who don't know, don't pay attention. You and Bert were doing this dunk challenge.
Well, if they know who Bert is, they know you broke your arm once. You know what I mean? For those of you who don't know, because a lot of people might not know him, but him and Bert were playing. Okay, but then they don't know Bert if they don't know this. So here it is. This is what it really looks like without a gradient, without that brutal pause gradient. Tom Segura is fully weird. Now, What kind of I'm telling, I wear some out there stuff. I'll wear a woman's dress. I'll wear a gown. I would never even know where to find this. This must be from one of those Spanish speaking stores in the mall that have a banner instead of an actual sign. And they're selling you God knows what type of suit for what type of event in Mexico.
That looks like an expensive jacket to me, but an expensive jacket for like Armenian guys.
Tom Segura is so stupid, but he tries to show, like, Tom Segura, believe it or not, tries to flex on us all the time. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, people don't really know.
That's a huge part of his personality.
He goes out and he cringily buys stuff. He actually, this is probably like a $5,000 jacket, right? From some...
I would say $1,200.
Really? No, I think it's even more. I would say it's like $2,400, and I think it's like a Balenciaga-level place like that.
Yes.
Okay. And I think he thinks we're going to be impressed. What he doesn't understand is the retards who watch this, they're looking at this coat, and what they're seeing is like a Mexican woman bus driver would wear something like this or something. You know, they're not impressed. And the buttons are as big as his fucking nipples. I mean, the buttons are these big. So I can make a pizza pie on this pan right here. Okay? You don't want to know what I could do. I used to launch these into space to get XM radio down to my receiver down there in my car. All right? That is a big, giant, oh, are you trying to match Joe? I know what this is.
So we were shooting content.
It's the dang flying saucer from Joe's sign. That's what it is. It must have fallen onto Tom's lapel. You know, and he's really patronizing, isn't he? And condescending. And the things that come out of his mouth are so slow and non-needed. Non-needed. But he talks with almost a mild intensity where you're paying attention as if something's coming out, right? But it never does. And then you go about your life thinking maybe you just missed something and you're the dumb one, huh? He's said nothing. He's never said anything. But he talks to you like this with the serious face. No, I understand. The jacket had to... And he talks with a seriousness that makes you think, okay, he's... And he know he must be onto something that we don't know about. No, no, no. He's as dumb as they come. And if it weren't for Rogan and a strike of good luck, he'd be with Denny and Melton. I'm not kidding. I mean, they used to all hang out, by the way. Him, Denny, and Melton. I'm not kidding. So it's almost like the world's biggest con, the world's most frustrating con, because you can't pin anything on this guy, right? I like can't prove it to you, but he's done this subtle trick to make people think that there's nothing being said. I've been duped into thinking, oh, look at this guy. He's got some. Listen to this.
For our live show, which was a New Year's Eve live. So that was like.
What the fuck? Shut the fuck up. You're lucky I'm not there to beat the living hell out of you. Okay.
I hated this interview with Tom. I didn't write down anything because I was just like, shut the fuck up, asshole.
And
for some reason, he's like so, like he's telling everybody, he's like, you need to start your own streaming service and you need to start your own pot. It's like, do you realize that not everybody needs to be, just because you got super excited about doing your mom's house live, that doesn't mean every single person on earth needs to start their own streaming service.
Talk about a penny scraper.
Oh, there's one part also where Joe goes, you know, on Apple Podcasts, the numbers were all way inflated because it was just anyone who subscribed to count it as a view or something like that.
Yeah.
And Tom was like, oh. Yeah, really. But he looked worried.
Yeah, he is worried because you know what? Tom Segura is a fucking phony. He's got nothing to say. And he's got no business having any money or any notoriety. And he is worried about his future. I'll tell you this. You could tell when somebody has as many revenue avenues as Tom Segura, it's because they think this is going to be a flash in the pan short. It's because they can't believe they're popular. I'll tell you this. The reason Tom Segura doesn't leave a dime on the table is because he knows people will move on any second, because even him himself can't believe that anyone would be this invested. So that's why he sells 1,700 shirts a month. That's why he's, when he's not forcing you to pay for bonus content or selling you shirts, he's doing a show. And when he's doing everything, he's got it. Every minute of the day, he's doing something to make more money. He's like Logan Paul. I don't know if you knew that about this guy.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if people know that. He's like the Logan Paul of
just
comedian podcasters.
Just look at his merch store. It'll tell you everything you need to know.
And everything. He's involved in hundreds of different micro, I call them schemes. I call, if you're trying to make money outside of a simple, honest, easy to understand way, I call that a scheme. And, oh my God, they got 200 separate money-making endeavors running at any given time. They're not leaving a dime or a second on the floor. And you're going, oh, maybe they think this could all be taken away in a second because maybe they don't even value what they're doing at all. You know, I'm getting anemically shaky right now.
Really?
Yeah, where I feel like I need some food, actually. I'm getting very dizzy. How long have we been broadcasting? Okay, thank God, 8 hours. Thank fuck. Okay. I was going, I'm feeling a little tired, and then I look at the clock. We're 20 minutes away from 8 hours.
Pretty much the only thing we have left to do is the crowd.
But I need some food. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to do 8 more hours. What do you say?
I know. I'm having a great time, despite my period.
Do you guys know when I do these red bars, I haven't eaten? Here's what happens. I wake up at about 9 a.m., and we launch the show at about 12 or 1. I don't eat. We wake up. I look over everything for the show. I wake up. I have coffee. And then I come in here. I take a 5-hour energy, and then I start drinking with you. So needless to say, I'm a little shaky. I had no idea. Bring him. I have no choice. Bring him. She doesn't understand me food-wise. No, that's okay.
Can I make my case?
Please, but give me the food, because it's an emergency.
And it's a fresh bag unopened, okay. so it doesn't have to be old food.
This is not an ad. I should have ate that salmon. Damn it! Ah! See, I was punished. The god punished me for doing that bit where I pretended I didn't like the salmon again and didn't eat it. I should have ate the salmon. I would have been fine.
I know. It was really good. I was sneaking bites for hours.
I'll tell you what she brought me. This is nothing I'd ever eat on my own.
But those, I think it'll be fine.
She buys. Do you guys have a wife who buys these nonsense things that you'd never even in a million years buy? I allow it. She handed me something. I had no idea this existed. Dang. It's a company called Dang.
I mean, that's stupid.
Thai rice chips toasted sesame. Would you ever in a million years pick this up at the grocery store as a guy? But a girl gets excited about stuff like this. So, and I'm starting to like.
That'll fill you. That's like I'm gonna a pass nice out. Crispy
so,
crunch.
I would never do this to you, but I got to eat these. Let's try it. You say they're good?
I love them.
You say they're good. Well, let's.
They're calling fucking that lib food.
Yeah, this is like lib food. Let's see.
See, it's like a little rice chip with a light toasted sesame crunch. See,
what's really good, and I feel a lot better. I'm sorry for doubting you.
I knew that would help your stomach.
Dang, these are good.
But you're eating into the mic now.
I know. Hold on. Let me just eat a little bit.
Here, should I play a song?
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Let me see what song I have for you boys.
Oh,
let's go to the Spotify.
I have to eat. Hurry up.
Like, fuck. What about a new song by The Offspring?
New music from The Offspring. We'll be right back.
Can you believe they're making songs still?
Long ago, we never have emotional strife. You never even threatened my life like you did. So long ago.
I'm sorry. New music from The Offspring. It's like if you were listening to the real radio, they do stuff like that all the time.
They put out 2 new songs, and the second one was way, way shittier than that, even.
I don't want to eat. I don't want to do any of this. This is all just to keep me going. Don't you want me to do more? I need some strength, but now we got to wait for this to kick in. How long does food take to kick in? Go on Reddit forums, swim.
Swim wants to know how long food takes to cook in. Kick it. You know, food isn't illegal, right? I don't know. All right. Let me get a wet wipe. Those are sticky, actually. Well, they leave a stick. Very good. Beta food.
They're pretty satisfying, though, right?
No.
I like
I'm
sesame.
Literally only eating them because I... What else am I going to do?
What, are you going to eat a Lay's chip?
We'll be right back. Oh, you didn't... Okay, here we go. Let me wipe up. Yeah, sorry, guys. I got really dizzy there. I got to regain because I got a lot more to say today. I'm not done. So I got to keep going. And but I don't want to pass out here. Blackout, I felt like I was woozy there. Ooh, I'm excited
God,
to eat.
Imagine if you did one of those midsummer faints in the show in front of everybody and I had to run over on the camera and be like, Mike, Mike, get up.
Oh, my God.
That would be.
And I passed out and flipped over. My pants fell off.
If you do pass out, do you want me to run over and save you despite being seen? Or do you want me to just quietly leave the room and leave you there for hours?
If I pass out? Yeah, I don't know. Just kick the computer or something. Okay. Tom Segura, right? You could kill that on your end there over on Spotify. And what were we talking about here? I nearly forgot.
His set. But you pretty much got your point across about that.
Got the point across. It's time to spend some fucking money. You heard about the sets.
There's a couple other Woods sets if you're interested, or we could do Crowder.
Yeah,
next.
No, let's see a couple Woods. I don't know if I could do. I am honestly very sick.
It's not that long. It's pretty short.
Good. Oh, yeah. The Creek in the Cave. Remember this loser fucking comic? I hate the Creek in the Cave. This isn't the picture. This isn't the picture. It's from the Facebook group. This isn't the picture I wanted to show.
Okay, I'll find it.
If you could find that, it's in the Facebook group. But we've got Janko made a wood wall. Is this true?
Yep.
Janko, no. 215. I love George Janko. I want to show that clip of George Janko. You know what I want to do instead of Crowder?
I would say that the Crowder thing is way better than the Janko thing. I'm just saying.
It doesn't matter if it's way better. It's about what I want to spend a lot of time with that Crowder thing. I got a lot to say. So you don't know that about me.
Okay.
Okay. I just don't want to do the Crowder thing. I want to spend an hour and a half on that. I don't have an hour and a half in me. That's the problem. Don't you understand how this thing works? You got to see George Janko, and we're really worried about him. So I want that other... Now you just told the whole audience that this George Janko clip isn't going to be funny. He said the Crowder thing's going to be funny. Oh, the Crowder thing's way better than this. Nah, they all want that.
I'm sorry.
What's wrong with you? It's a good thing the stream just went down. All right, let's show the Janko thing first. So this is a warning, but I want that other Janko thing queued up. But this is, oh, no, Janko, no, don't do it. And you won't believe it. You really won't believe it. Look at this. Here he goes. And he's about to open a door. I don't even remember. He says, I caught this guy at my house. Here's the video. Janko, no.
Put everything all in here, right? And we're trying to set this up today to make it look nice. Simi?
Yes.
I thought about this. You know how the Impulsive has wood background?
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of man and chic. What if we did a different type
chic.
Of background? That kind of has to do like with wood.
Uh-oh.
Guys,
Janko appears to be building an office in his all-white home. And he said, you know how Impulsive has a wood background? It looks really chic. What if we did a wood wall? I can't. Does he show it or does he just say
remember?
That? Oh, my God.
Reaction
there
channel.
We go.
I'll put the link in the description. I'm actually very excited about this channel.
I couldn't believe it.
It's
He's
my
making
way
a new reaction channel.
Riff,
this is what this is for.
Tell some jokes while watching some stuff. And I'm really excited about it. It's like a little passion project I'm doing.
Why is he allowed to have so many different girlfriends? Every time I see him, he's with a different girl.
Go to 435 to see it.
So I just can't believe it's like every day I wake up and they're just woodenizing everyone I love. Imagine if you like on TV and all of a sudden all your favorite shows that you watch, sitcoms, just all went wood. I mean, it really wouldn't line up. Oh, my God. Wait, can we show this? Not bad. Watch this. Here's Janko at Lowe's. Janko at Lowe's buying wood. Okay. So the woodening has begun. And is there anything funny when he talks to
if
this guy?
He goes
guy?
To four. It's just regular Janko behavior.
Sure.
How is it that I've came here like 4 or 5 times and the customer service has been through the roof? Like, I'm being so serious. We brought this up last time. What do they pay you in gold or something? Like, what is going on? Every single person I meet here is so happy. And
I don't know. I like working here. I'm.
You like working at Home Depot? Don't stop talking to the staff, Janko. You know, he's like that guy who goes to the strip club and goes, "You're really beautiful. You know, you could be anything you want. You don't have to."
He thinks he's being so nice, but he's being so condescending. Yeah.
Dude, why are you working here? You seem so much better than this. I actually enjoy it. You enjoy putting on gloves and a mask and handing people wood? It's crazy, then.
Like, renovating my bathroom right now, so I just...
That's awesome. You do, like, home construction?
Not home construction. Like, just renovation. I'd like to do home construction.
Only Janko can film in a Lowe's. You're goddamn right, someone said. Everyone else just like, sir, you can't film. Not Janko. He could film wherever the fuck he wants.
We're going to try to do that today. We're not really. He's a bodybuilder. That guy's just like a comedian. I don't really know how we're going to do that. He'll break the walls down. He'll tell a joke.
You're a bodybuilder and a comedian. You don't
buy it all.
Wow.
Thank you so much. Cool. I appreciate it.
Here it comes. The big reveal is about to come.
Oh. Could you cover your, put your mask on when you, thank you. Dude, this is how, I'm not exaggerating, this is how this dude was walking. He's like, oh, yep, I know exactly what it is. Follow me.
Okay. It's a nice ass, though.
Yeah, so this is going to be our stainless steel. Oh, you want a new one? Oh, yeah, no problem. Just right over here. Just right over here. Yep, right over here. Right over here. Yeah. Let's test it out.
Okay, where's this fucking wall already?
Did you hold this side right
here? Wow. Oh, it's beautiful. So this is how these wood walls come to be. They go to look at this. He literally is picking it out.
This is a behind the scenes.
This is a behind the scenes of how these wood walls come to be. And this is new. Can you believe this is all happening at once, all this woodening? And
you're a whiny.
I stop with this fucking soundboard. I'm going to break it over my own head and electrocute myself soon. But imagine if we could have tape of all of them. I always wanted to know, how do they do it? They go to Home Depot, they see this wood, and they go, I could staple that to the wall, which to them makes it worthy.
I think they literally do staple it to the wall. Later
yeah,
in the video.
Watch this.
Did you hold this side really?
Amazing.
It's like a good vibe. You got it?
This is how it comes to be. And then he's going to hold this up so I can see what it looks like.
Oh, shit. How are we going to put this in there? Deadass, you think that's going to work?
1,000%.
I don't know.
You know what we should do during the next break? Download a couple pictures of wood and put them on these screens. I'll be in the wood room myself in 2 minutes. No, let's do that in the next show.
Okay.
Write that down. The next time you see me, I'm going to be woodenized. We'll see what it's like doing Red Bar Woody. Wood edition. All right, let's see what happens next.
Oh, if I trust that.
I don't know. That mask makes me trust him a little more.
Yeah, right?
It looks more like a... Listen. Like
he doesn't, I'm gonna go ahead and just veto all this and... Get one of these. Get all the things. Just order an Uber. Put this in the car.
But this may not fit in an Uber vehicle.
An XL, yeah, well.
You can go to 7:30 if you want to see him in the set.
Dang. All right, 7:30. And here it comes, guys. You're going to see how this shit happens, how this shit comes together. It's pretty epic. So it is the host takes his own drill.
Yes,
it's so crooked.
No, it's not.
You
need to go in the middle like this.
That would be exactly perfect.
Well, yes, it should be exactly perfect.
Yeah, you don't like the look.
It's not even the look. Point. You know, like this is my thing and everybody cares about it. They're like, no, if you're going to do it, you're going to do it right.
There it is.
You know what, mate? It's good.
You screwing it in. You need to
check
in the walls.
Yeah. Nice. Looks awesome. Looks really executive.
So you guys are seeing us. We're building this. It's happening one step at a time. So if you want to go to the description, click the link. And
it literally is. This is like fence material. This is like, you know that, what is that, cedar? What do they use for like a fence in a person's backyard? The standard fence material. And he's literally sitting in front of it in an office chair 2 inches from the fucking wall. I mean, it's just not done. Unfinished. You go like this. Oh, my God. Your hand would be splinterized in second. I mean, it would shred like cheese if you rubbed your hand against this wall. So I just don't understand what is happening. It doesn't look good. You would never walk in. You walked into somebody's office like this, you'd turn immediately and walk around the other way. You'd be so scared. So let's see what happens here.
Subscribe to a reaction channel that's being built. You know, that way you're feeling like you're a part of the ground floor of this company.
This company.
Oh, dude. We should play basketball. Before we go play basketball, can we just take a second?
Oh, I hate when vlogs... A lot of vlogs lose themselves to basketball. So what they'll do is they'll start playing basketball. And then they realize, like, they'll forget that we're here. And it's not just a fun pickup game with their friends. And they'll show you the whole basketball game. I've got stuck watching whole basketball games of these people all the time. Blake Linder, him. That's about it. Let's show you Janko. We never thought this could happen. Because usually we're... Janko could do no wrong, right? And I'm really, like, physically ill. So we got to end after this, unfortunately.
We'll do the Crowder stuff next episode, I promise.
Trust me. You just trust me, always. Every fucking time, trust me.